Now let's redo our example and pretend that instead of being a line charge, let's make it thicker. Let's make this be a surface charge density. The surface charge density is going to go from 1 to 3 in the x direction, and it's going to go from 2 to 3 in the y direction. The surface charge density, Js, is going to be 3 amps per meter squared, and it's going to be going in the x direction. So how do we approach this problem? The same way as before. We write our RS expression. Here's our convenient origin right there, and here is a picture of RS. RS is the vector from the origin to some location right here on my source. So it's going to be XS in the x direction plus YS in the y direction. But in this case, YS is not constant. It varies from 2 to 3, so we can't set that equal to a constant. It's going to stay as YS. Then, let's draw a vector from the origin to the location where we would like to find the field point. Let's say that we would still like to find the field point any place along the y-axis. So that means that we're going to find it at xpx plus ypy, but we can see that xp is equal to 0 because I'm on the y-axis. Then I'm going to find r, which is the vector from the source to the point where I want to find my field. Right here would be a picture of rsp. That is always equal to rp minus rs, which is yp, which is minus xs in the x direction plus yp minus ys in the y direction. The unit vector is going to be r divided by the magnitude of r, and the magnitude of r is going to be xs squared plus yp minus ys squared, all square rooted. So now we found all of the vectors that we're going to be using. The next thing that we need is our I. I in this case is js ds. Let's figure out what ds is. Ds is a little piece of surface right here on my rectangular cross section. So it is dxs and dys. Now why did I put the s's down there? I put the s's to remind me that I'm adding up all of these little pieces of my source, or integrating them. And it's the sources that I'm adding up, it's the sources I'm integrating, not the points where I want to find the field. Now let's go and apply our cross product. This cross product is going to work exactly the same as the previous cross product, or very close. So let's see how that works. We want to find I cross R. So let's draw our 3x3 matrix, x minus y and z. Our x is going to be jx dxs dys and 0 in the y's and z's. Right there is where I put I. And then down here I'm going to put r. R is minus xs in the x direction. It's xp, it's yp minus ys in the y direction, and it's 0 in the z direction. So again, when I do my cross product, I'm going to get essentially the same thing that I did before. What I'm going to get is in the z direction, jx dxs dys times yp minus ys. There's my cross product. Now let's apply the Biot-Savart law. I cross R divided by 4 pi R cubed. Just plug everything in here and it's going to be ready to integrate. I'm going to bring the z hat vector to the outside. Just move that over here so that you remember that what that means is this is the direction that the magnetic field is in. And we're going to divide this by 4 pi xs squared plus yp minus ys squared square rooted cubed.